China's big Tibet anniversary parade was very much a closed affair. The BBC was not given an invitation, of course, so we've had to rely on state-run TV for the pictures of the goose-stepping paramilitary troops, the flag-waving onlookers, and the other symbols of Communist Party rule being paraded through the streets of Lhasa, all supposed to portray a sense of undivided national unity. Chinese troops entered Tibet in 1950, but it wasn't until 1965 that Beijing implemented the current system of political control, establishing the territory as one of China's so-called autonomous regions. In theory, the status should give Tibet more political autonomy than other provinces, but in practice, critics say the Tibetan language and culture have faced heavy repression. This unverified video posted on Twitter reportedly shows a protest by a Tibetan monk this week. Holding what is said to be a picture of the Dalai Lama aloft, he is very quickly subdued by Chinese security forces. In his speech before the parade, one of China's most senior politicians, Yu Zhengsheng, dismissed the Dalai Lama as a violent separatist opposed to progress. The Chinese Communist Party and the Tibetan people have led the transformation from a backward old Tibet to a vibrant socialist new Tibet, he said. In a statement, the London-based rights group Free Tibet criticized what it called the ongoing propaganda effort to rewrite Tibetan history. And it posed a question. If the Tibetan people really have such a good news story to tell, why doesn't the Chinese government let them freely tell it? And why doesn't it allow the world's media in to see it for themselves? John Sudworth, BBC News, Beijing.